G'day, this is Simon from the Bracketeer at South OC Cars and Coffee, and I have Greg with me. He has a ultra cool car of the week. What is it, Greg?
It is a 1937 Chevy Rat Rod truck.
It is so cool. This is not like anything I've seen before. Wait till you check it out. Amazing. Greg, right from the onset, right from the front, this thing is imposing. It looks to me like somebody stole your headlights and replaced them with a couple of turbos and air cleaners. What's going on with that?
I figure turbos are more useful than headlights are.
Yeah, I think they are. I mean, you don't hear about headlights making more power. Although, you know, if you use one of those electric turbos you see on eBay for $100, I'm sure that'd work really well. So tell me about this thing. You built it yourself.
Yes, sir.
It's a ground up, obviously. Chassis and everything looks really cool. Tell me, where did it start and how did you end up here?
It started sitting in a field up in Utah and was just rusting away. And I brought it to my house in October of 2020 and have spent pretty much every day since then putting 10 plus hours a day on this.
Yeah, it absolutely shows. I mean, there's so many little details on it. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about that engine. Obviously, it's a small block Chev.
Yep.
What cubic inch are you looking at there?
It's 383 cubic inches.
Yep.
Stroker.
Yep. So 350 straight down to 383.
Yep.
High rise manifold on it. You've also got fuel injection on it, which is kind of cool as well. So it looks same bolt pattern as running a Holley, but it's actually fuel injection, yeah?
Correct.
And then obviously, you got an intercooler run in the front. You got blow off valves down there. Have you actually put this thing on a dyno?
Not yet.
And what, guessing?
Guessing it's around 1,000 horsepower. The motor itself was 600 before the turbo.
Was it really? And what fuel you're running in it?
Right now I'm running 91 with a lot of additive.
Additive, yeah. Yeah, you'd absolutely need that with 91. So really cool interior as well. I love what he's done with those fabricated seats. Did you buy them like that?
Those seats, yes, I purchased like that. And interior's not done yet. It's getting some carpet and some brown diamond stitch.
That's cool.
On the roof and behind the seats.
Yeah, I really like it because it's a cool look. Fuel cell in the back, obviously. What rear end are you running under the back of it, Greg?
Right now, it just has a Ford 8.8 rear end with a mini spool.
Does it? Right. Okay. Yeah, it's really interesting. I mean, did you sketch something out of what you wanted, or did you just start building and see where it took you?
I just started building and used my imagination along the way.
Yeah, I mean, the exhaust, for instance, I love what you've done there, which is good. You got Magnaflow on it. Those guys are obviously going to like that there down the road. This is a really cool-looking truck. I mean, honestly, it's the sort of thing, you saw this thing coming down the road at you, it's probably going to scare you. It's, you know, it's kind of crazy. So, a really well-deserved car of the week. I love this thing. I think it stands out really well. Really well. As our winner of car of the week, you get this Meguiar's complete kit, including the polishing sponge, cleaner wax, scratch remover, car wash, glass cleaner, interior detailer, hot shine foam. I don't know how much of that you're going to be able to use on this patina, but I know you've got other cars as well, so
I do.
You should be fine. Very good job, Greg. Congratulations and thanks for bringing it out today.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.